Yahweh before the God Sabi, across the path of divine human, the low-floating minds of light, alone in the hundred temples of eternity, they step through by the unsilent command, almost one face open, in and through, in the somber symbol of the highest beauty, the wisdom that embodies the infinite, the fathomless hero occupies the world, the fathomless hero. Venom is a mark on a rope to measure the depth of the water. One, two, three, four. You tie the heavy weight group and mark it one pattern, two pattern, three pattern, and then complete 200 meters. And then you say, but not here, this is venom. You cannot really measure the depth of this void, this ocean. Venom is zero. Venom is at the sense of water. Ocean. Zero, nothing. What? Shunya. Now, this is exactly what we have in the Nasadhyaya Sutta. Nasadhyaya Sutta speaks of Shalilam Aparketam. Shalilam Aparketam. The inconscient ocean. The inconscient ocean. Shalilam. What? Aparketam. They are not consciousness at all. It is that which he goes. The creation starts with that. Actually, in that sense, the description what we have in Savitri goes even one step back to what is there in the Nasadhyaya Sutta. Nasadhyaya Sutta assumes first Sriram Aparketam in the conscient ocean. But before the inconscient ocean appears, they got a void. They got a pure shunya. They got a zero. They got a cipher. They got a cipher. Now this cipher has to be deciphered. Has to be understood. This cipher has to be deciphered. Cipher means in English language code. You have to unravel the code for the whole thing. What is the zero? What is the cipher? What we have to decipher that. And the entire business of this canto is that how to decide that canto. See, how the freedom in constant ocean appears in the world. See, first thing is the Jagadu Nasadhyaya Sutta, what we have here, the beginning of Savitri, what we have is the appearance of the fathomless hero, the void, the supreme. Emptying himself out completely. The first nothingness, the absolute, with all the possibilities and all the potentialities which are not come into manifestation, he has emptied himself out completely and he has become the last nothingness. Now, it is about last nothingness, out of that zero, he will have to start appearing. That cipher has to be a cipher from the dawn to here. So, that is important. What is the issue there? The issue is basically of creating, of bringing out of this last nothingness, the zero, the cipher, a creation in divine multiplicity. Rahusyam Prajapati. I want to be many, there is a will to the supreme. And in order to carry out that will, to be many, he empties himself out so that nothing of this is there. Otherwise, new creation cannot be there. See, you can remember, even if you pick, that is not what new creation is about. He empties himself out completely there. And then, out of that nothingness, a real new creation can be received. The whole idea behind the zero of cycle you see. Now, who is going to make this new creation? New creation can be brought out, can come out. Only when somebody comes here and does the necessary yoga tapasya to bring out the yoga kind of a vidic yajna as it carried out to bring out a new creation here. So the Supreme Himself comes here to Naktar and then there he goes. Ashwapati comes for that purpose. comes from time to time and takes off your treatment for that. See, that is yoga tapasya, for this new creation. Once that new creation, that new tapasya has been created, then with my Shakti, takes it forward, you see, on the then something within spiritual dark sister, in name this moment, and unthought again. Here is now the moment when he comes in full preparedness. Ashwati comes in full preparedness. Come and does yoga tapasya. In that yoga tapasya, he is the birth of his own supreme power. Divine Shakti is coming for him. The transcendental power, the divine Shakti, our birth in this inconscient world, in mortality, the mortal world. It is in that mortal world, there is the assurance of giving this path of divine event. Our center. Savitri is the account of this world of yoga tapasya and divine power action. The complete Savitri is this one. Yoga tapasya and divine power action. Both are important. That is the biographical of the now, well, we skip about these things because there's no time in the world. We are going straight to part A of Savitri. Ashwapati immediately said to the triple yoga. I just explained to you. Now, in the triple yoga, the first is, of course, the individual yoga, the release of the soul from ignorance, and as I said, ignorance extends all the way up to the overmind. Even spiritual planes are also a part of that ignorance. The real knowledge starts from the transcendental, from supermind forward. Much had already happened. Now, we have got at the very beginning of this canto, third canto, ecstatic oneness and dynamic power descended in Ashwapati. Ecstatic oneness and dynamic power. The integral Godhead's three, both are necessary for the integrality of the description of the Godhead. Ecstatic oneness and the dynamic power. His soul and body can be stand. Now, static oneness and dynamic power. These were the two siddhis of Sri Vendu. As early as in January 1908 and August 1908. We can actually pinpoint the dates. Biographically, this is biographically. When did he get the static? I will say around first on 1st January 1928. See, during the Surat Congress in 1927, Sri Vendu had come to Surat from Calcutta, going to at that time. And after the conference was over, he stayed for a few days in Baroda, where he was earlier also. In Baroda, he fell a brain and arranged the meeting of Gere with Sri Vendu. And Gere and Sri Vendu sat in a room for 3 days without any contact with him at all. And with the directions of Gere, Sri Vendu got the position of what is called the silent mind. That silent mind is around 1st January 1918. Silent mind is 1918. Now, silent mind is another description in a poetic way, in a metaphysical way, in the language tradition, is static oneness, that silent mind, oneness. Now this happened in January, and then in May, because of his political activity, because his charges of sedition, of waging a war against the crown, he was imprisoned, he was incarcerated for 1 year in Alipur Jail. He was in Alipur Jail on 5th May. And then 8 to 15, 19, for 1 year. So in fifth May it was that in here in Yoga Tattvasya thought and intensified at one point of time. Fifth time said, I put the Gita in his hand and he will follow the Yoga of the Gita. At another point, the spirit of Vivekananda would appear in front of me almost for 2 weeks and point out at the golden star up in the sky. Golden star up in the sky, in the light, golden star, supermind. He didn't say it's supermind, but the meaning was very clear that he was pointing out as supermind. Now he followed golden gates and then he had a vision of his whole universe, his whole creation filled with divine presence. Vasudeva, Vasudeva, Vasudeva. He goes to the court, he goes here, he goes everywhere. He sees nothing but Vasudeva. Dynamic presence of Vasudeva. Everywhere active. And then what they got here? Dynamic power. So you have now the static oneness and dynamic power. 1st January, around July, August, and now these two major siddhis have become the foundation for these yoga. These are traditional Vedic siddhis. People respect the static oneness and then they call the whole world an illusion. Maya, you respect only this. If you start with dynamic power, you can really prove the significance of the creation of the world. So, Srivatan has something. Now, this is something absolutely remarkable. We think life and lives to get one of the siddhis, and within 6 months he got both. Of course, he had been doing sadhana for life after life, but then he kind of recollected it immediately and starts to happen. That is one that can happen. So, you can pinpoint biographically. See, in fact, within that time, in the dream, he rises for Ishvara and Ishwari. The day of Ishvara and the day of Ishwari. All the same are there, automatically there. He has also the descriptions of the Vedic goddesses coming and telling him, you are Saraswati, Mahim, Bhati, all these things are telling him. So all these things are there. All the things happen between 9 and 8 and 9 and 11. The moment he comes to Pondicherry and he identifies those visions with the goddesses, you see. So within 3-4 years, he has got a complete range on the traditional spiritual realization, and that becomes the foundation. Of course, with the realization of the supermind. Supermind, full knowledge may not be there at that point, but he knows that this is the thing. He something has got to be done. It is this alone which can do this thing. A long imprecation in man's life, a circle of toil and hope and war and peace. That life, that part of my life on matters obscure ground, it is mine to be ever proud. He seeks through a penumbra, shortest way, and will get the heart known, ever thing. A service for something or someone, a service for something or someone never found. Current of an ideal is ever made here, and end to spiral into ascent and fall. Until at last it reached the chance point through which his glory shines, for whom we permit his glory, that supernatural light, supernatural sun, supernatural, all appearance, shine one for way, and we break into the infinity of God, we break into the infinity of God, we can really break into the infinity of God, only then that glory shines in us, this supernatural light shines in us, and they can, well, we can, we have got a mental light, we have got a spiritual light, now that we. That is of a limited nature. It is a light of the right kind, but still a light of ignorance. It is not the glory, it is